Hello everyone, it's Finansetti, and today we're going to be talking about staking. I'm going to tell you what staking is, how you can earn money from it, and where the easiest way to do it is. Okay, so let's start with what is staking. What you need to know is that the way that the cryptocurrencies work is that they're adding information onto the main list of transactions every once in a while. And every time that transactions are added to the list, the people who are adding these transactions to the list are getting rewarded. So what are the two main mechanisms by which cryptocurrencies are making sure that the list is actually true and not being interfered with by bad actors? Well, they use what's called a consensus mechanism. And the consensus mechanism is how they verify every transaction on the list to make sure that it's true, to make sure that no one is making false transactions for their own benefit, and it maintains the integrity of the network. So we need to talk about the two main consensus mechanisms that exist. One is proof of work, and it's what Bitcoin uses. And the second one is proof of stake, which is a little more recent and much, much, much more energy efficient. Here's what you need to know about both of them. In proof of work, you're rewarded because everybody on the network simultaneously solves a very complicated math problem in order to create the next set of transactions on the list. And whoever is pretty much the first one to do it, well, once everybody checks it and agrees that the first guy who did it was correct and is not manipulating the network badly, well, then he gets the rewards for adding the transactions to the main list. As you can tell, this is extremely energy inefficient because everybody on the network at the same time tries to solve this math problem, and it's pretty much first come, first serve. So very energy inefficient. Now we talk about the second one, which is called proof of stake. Do you see? Proof of stake, staking, we're getting somewhere. All right, some proof of stake, instead of everybody on the network doing the same math problem, what happens is that one or two or a couple of people are selected from the whole network to actually come up with a valid next set of transactions for the list. And everybody else waits on the sidelines, waits for those guys to propose something. And once the selected few propose something, everybody else on the network is checking it based on rules. And this is how the proof of stake consensus mechanism works. Now, what's the incentive here? Well, if everybody else decides, hey, this guy actually didn't submit an honest list of transactions and something there was false. Well, the way that staking works is that instead of providing huge amounts of computing power, the network is secured by everybody actually putting up their own wallet. Their own money is at stake. So if you do something bad, literally, they will take your money away from you as punishment. Whereas if you actually proposed a next list of transactions that were good, well, then you get rewarded because everyone is like, thank you for participating. Thank you for proposing something honest. This is your reward for participating in the blockchain. That's the main difference between the two. And because in proof of work, only a couple of people are actually doing the computing required to create the next list of transactions, it's like orders of magnitude, like thousands, ten thousands, literally orders of magnitude more energy efficient than the proof of work consensus mechanism. And that's why there's a big push right now for everybody to switch to the proof of stake mechanism. Now, in order for a proof of stake mechanism to be secure, you need a certain amount of individual stakers, right? Before we had miners, now we have stakers. So you need a certain amount of stakers to stake a certain amount of their currency. And once you reach that threshold, then you have a secure proof of stake network. So how can you participate in either the mining or in the staking and actually make money from that? Well, what you would do is either you can yourself run a server to participate in the staking or the mining, which I wouldn't recommend. What most people are doing, because actually doing it yourself, you pretty much can't do it. It's especially mining, like you need such expensive equipment and access to such cheap energy that it's totally not worth it. And with staking as well, there's minimum thresholds, and like they try to manipulate the reward mechanisms in the blockchains so that there's like a certain amount of staked coins by each single like individual who's staking. So what happens in reality is that people are actually giving up their money to pools. And this is either a mining pool or in proof of stake, you delegate your coins to someone else. And this is kind of the mechanism that most exchanges are taking advantage of. And this is the delegation of your coins towards someone who is actually actively participating in maintaining the network. So now that we understand how the mechanism works, and how you actually are able to make money from this consistently, because every time you add a list of transactions, well, you get a predefined amount of rewards. Let me show you how easy it is to do it on Binance. This is not an advertisement for Binance. I wish I was sponsored by them, but I'm not. So just have a look at this. So if you Google Binance staking, you're gonna come to this website, and make sure you come to the locked staking because this is the one I'm talking about. DeFi staking is more complicated, so we're not gonna get into that for today. So in locked staking, what happens is that you decide duration of days where you're willing to lock up your currency and give it to one of these staking or mining pools. In this case, I think they're all staking pools. And then at the end of these days, you're given your money back as well as this percentage reward. Now, one thing to make sure that you guys don't get the wrong impression here, this number listed here is the APY, the annual percentage yield. That means if you held your coins with this fund for 365 days, this is what you get. As you can see here, nothing is here for 365 days, so you have to make the correct math to figure out exactly how much you're gonna get. But actually, you don't need to do that, because check this out. If you press, for example, I wanna stake for 30 days, and bear in mind that depending on the amount of days you stake, well, they can offer a different amount of rewards, and that's actually quite normal. So let's say you pick, okay, I wanna do it for a month. Well, you press this, then you go here and you press check, and Binance, well, okay, it's asking me to log in, but Binance gives you a really nice window where it just tells you, hey, all right, if you put this amount in, this is how much you're gonna get at the end. It's listed there, it's very transparent. You don't even actually need to do the calculation by yourself. That's how staking works. And if you wanna see what kind of products Binance actually offers, well, some of the biggest ones, here's Binance Coin, giving you a duration of 15, 30, 60, or 90 days. These are all sold out because this was a big promotion that appeared the past day. This was actually sold out within 24 hours. So this pool is full and is not accepting any new coins. Well, if you go down a little bit, we have Polkadot and we have Cardano here. And Cardano, if you go 30, 60, 90, I think the maximum is like seven or nine, which is, and as you can see here, this one is also sold out. But if you go down to the 60 and the 30 days, well, these are available. Let's check Polkadot. Polkadot is sold out on all days. But as you can see here, as I'm cycling through, well, the percentages change a little bit for all of them. And when you actually look on the official websites there, if you look hard enough, you'll see what the average yield is. And in general, the one that Binance gives you is pretty close to what you would get if you actually went through the official ways and you made up your specific wallet that's only supported by these guys, which is enabled for staking. And it's a huge amount of logistics that you need to do, which you can do. Your rewards are going to be like a couple of base percentage points higher. But in my opinion, the easiest way for you guys to do it is to just make a Binance account, go here to the locked staking page, decide, all right, I want to lock up and stake my Cardano for 30, 60, 90 days. And at the end of the 90 days, I'm going to receive what I would receive if I was earning 9.32 annual interest on the amount I staked. So I don't know, let's say, for super quick math, just divide this by 12 and you'll get approximately what you want if you stake for 1 month, right? There's 12 months in a year, divide by 12, because this is the annual number, you'll get approximately there. The math isn't exactly like that, but that's a pretty good approximation. So guys, that's how I recommend staking. And let me just go down here a little bit further, because you might be wondering as well what they have for Ethereum. And I do believe that they do offer Ethereum 2.0 staking already. Let me double check that for you guys. So Binance does offer Ethereum 2.0 staking, but what you have to know about this is that the lockup period for this type of staking is going to be much longer, because Anybody who locks up their Ethereum right now and waits for the Ethereum 2.0 upgrade to finish has to wait that whole period of time until Ethereum 2.0 finishes upgrading, and only at that moment are they going to get their Ethereum back as well as the extra rewards that they got from that. So the lockup period is much, much longer than the other ones on offer for Ethereum 2.0. Now, as always, you can, of course, go to whatever cryptocurrency you like, and if it offers staking, just go to its official site, see what wallet it supports, and I'm sure that through that wallet, you'll be able to do staking only with that coin. I like Binance because it's a little bit more convenient. You can see pretty much everything that's on offer, and it's kind of, you know, I take a couple percentage points hit, but I have so much more peace of mind. And anyway, staking is probably only going to be a small percentage reward on my currency compared to what you're going to get from the currency appreciating. And for me, it's just a bit of convenience to have it on the exchange. Of course, if you want to be 100% secure, it's always, always recommended to, in that case, then just go and make your own wallet by yourself. But you might lose the keys. You might do something wrong. I don't know. For me, it's just convenient to keep it on the exchange for now. If I had significantly more amount of money of, like, I don't know, my total amount invested in everything into cryptocurrencies, I would probably consider making my own wallet. But if you're only keeping a small percentage into these cryptocurrencies, which is what I would recommend, to stay below 10% for sure, and I would even recommend lower, like 2 or 3%, and just seeing what happens, well, in that case, I think it's fine to leave it just on an exchange and take advantage of all the features that are there. I showed you what staking is, where it comes from, and the easiest place I found to do it, where you're still going to get a majority of the rewards for it without going through a bunch of technical hoops and opening up a million different wallets for every single coin. I do think Binance offers great staking options for us, so that's my recommendation. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Please like and subscribe if it was worth it and you got smarter today. Thank you. Bye.